I've always had mixed match, like literally kitchen cabinets or like dumb things. We have two tiny ass little shelves that I could not be more fired up about. We're able to do something that I have been dreaming of doing for a long time, but I need your guys' help. If you guys follow me on Instagram, you saw a couple weeks ago I posted this sick ass Hot Wheels like collection this guy has. This thing is super tight. I asked you guys if you'd be down to help me build one, and you all said yes. So you guys know right now my Hot Wheels collection is like, it's like your average guy's Hot Wheels collection. Anyways, this is simple. We have a new P.O. box near our new house. I need you guys to send as many Hot Wheels as physically possible to this address right here. You guys can order them online and send them straight to the P.O. box. You guys can collect them for a little while and then send like a bulk amount. The more Hot Wheels you guys send, the bigger this collection will be. It's gonna be intense. And what I want you guys to do is write your Instagram, or if you don't have Instagram, write some sort of social media that I can tag you guys in on the box, on the packaging, on anything. I'm gonna build something like this, but a little bit better. And then underneath each car, I'm gonna put your Instagram tag. I literally could not do this by myself. So I need to make sure that like I pay my respect to everybody that can help me do this. You guys know sometimes the smallest mods are the absolute best ones. Same thing goes for house mods, boys. Check this thing out. So this thing here, let me explain. So our new house is in a really small town with like absolutely no street lights, no ambient lights, no light pollution, nothing. Which means you can't see f*** all out here at night. So like the outside of the shop has these sconce lights on them. The issue with those is that they're no good until you actually get to the garage to get to the switch to turn them on. And like you could use a flashlight to walk around, but it's kind of a pain in the ass to like flashlight around and carry stuff. You gotta carry stuff or something. So after we've been here for a couple weeks and I'm making like pitch black trips back and forth to the shop at night, I'm like, dude, there has to be a better solution. And boy, is this it. So this is
Go Sun.
This isn't a sponsor video. I bought this off Amazon. I wouldn't complain about a sponsorship though, because dude, having these in every single outlet in my entire house would be the best. So check it. Oh damn, literally just having like paddle switches or whatever you want to call these, so much better. So I got this thing all paired up with my Google Homes because I'm a big Google Home guy. So now it works as a switch, but also
I can hit it from my phone before I go outside, which is rad.
But because I'm super lazy, I'll probably just ask Google on my way out of the house, like, hey Google, turn on the shop lights. Super dope.
There's two things you can count on in life. The first one is if I just bought something, you can bet your ass I'm gonna stand on it and take a photo. And the second one is if I have the chance, I'm probably gonna build some shit. So this morning we drove to the third closest Home Depot on my map. It was like just over an hour away because they're the only place that has these cabinets that I really want to get for the garage. They match my toolbox. They're kind of necessarily dope. I ordered them online. I got a plan. We got some shit. And before we go inside, the only way you're gonna be having a matching dope fit with me is if November 19th at 12 p.m. EST, you guys cop one of these masks and one of these hoodies from thecommittedcrew.com. Bro, it's freezing. We gotta go. Don't miss the drop, dude. Unless you like uncomfortable masks. If you like uncomfortable masks, then wear one.
Like mine.
Like this. Because I forgot mine, so I stole Courtney.
Something that I try to tell you guys to do sometimes is just appreciate things when they're happening. And like earlier this year, I took Courtney's cross trek to Home Depot to pick up all the wood when we built the loft at the warehouse. You guys see me beat on this truck all the time. I use it for a million things, but this is like the first time we picked up just a bunch of lumber with it. I also got my special cabinets. Sometimes those moments like randomly spring up on you, like right now, where I'm just appreciating the fact that like I have this thing. I'm not loading wood in the cross trek.
Appreciate it.
Sorry.
When it happens. We basically made two different options here. We're going with this one, I think. Cause
yeah,
like,
yeah, I think so. I think the bottom looks, it's solid.
I just want to make as much like tool bench area as possible in the garage. And like I wanted to build one across like the whole wall, which we're still kind of doing, but I didn't want it to be fully stationary. The issue that we ran into already is like, this is not a warehouse anymore, but we have leveled up to the point where we have trucks now.
Yeah, true.
So the problem is like, we brought the taco in here the other day and the taco with the door closing comes pretty close to the front and leaves you.
Without even the full truck in, the bumper came to like probably here.
That's what I mean. With the door closing, it's, you're out of room. Right?
I don't even know if your truck would fit here.
Yeah, I don't know either, dude. It's pretty big. Either way, our idea that I think is gonna be solid, the air compressor kind of all the way to the center point of the garage, and then from the center point on, we'll put the toolbox and the table with some wheels on it. That way, if we want to pull a truck or something in the future, we always have the option to rip that stuff out. Whereas this one, we're gonna like bolt to the wall, make it super secure, put the vise on it, and we're good and solid and set.
I'm thinking what would be real tight, you paint this black, and then you have this guy like this.
Oh yeah.
But wood.
Yeah, dude,
instead of having
dope.
It on top of the frame, you have it like,
you have it sunk in.
Sunk in, like recessed in the frame.
Yeah.
And I think that'd look real tight as like wood, and it would like, I said a lot of likes, but.
So when I first did all these measurements, I didn't recess the bench. I put the bench on top like I've done in the past. Now my measurements might be a little so we might have to take a quick little trip to get some more wood, all I'm saying. Way to go.
We're just gonna make it extra fresh. Robbie wants to build a workbench, and then I come and screw up his plans.
you come and you're like, you spent how much at Home Depot? No, we'll go spend more.
It's not my money.
It's 10 feet long, so it was kind of hard to like, on the floor we kept moving it around because like we couldn't find a spot where it was like super flat. You know what, dude? Good call on the countersink.
Once they're all screwed and tapped in,
ooh.
Oh, it's gonna look fresh.
I bet your tall, lanky ass likes the height, eh?
Oh, dude, for me, this is gonna be so nice on my back, doing whatever, I don't know, who knows what we're gonna be doing here.
Because like when you're working on something, even like you throw something here and you're trying to like weld it, right? It's like, you don't have to like, do this, right, like squat, it's just like, you can't buy, when you go to the store and you buy something, it's not this big.
Our first game, buddy, if this goes off the table and crashes, we're
this one came together way easier than the other one, probably because we knew what we were already doing. We ran into the store, grabbed one more 2x4, literally all we needed to finish this up. So we put a cross brace here, and then on this one we did this little angle piece too, just to give it a little bit of extra rigidity because we are gonna put the wheels. We could have actually upgraded to a bigger wheel, but like when we test fitted these ones, they actually look really good in use versus how dinky they look not being used.
Damn. Dude, that's so minty. Oh my god, I can't believe it. It's beautiful.
What we're gonna go ahead and do for this, because we already spent way too much money on this project, and we're gonna just make sure that this one is like a top tier. We have these for a very long time and they look dope. We're gonna go ahead and paint/stain these benches up. What I picked up here is like a Rust-Oleum. It's like this. It's literally the same thing as like what you would get in a spray can, except it's brush on, because I feel like we'd be idiots to spray bomb this whole thing. We're gonna brush it on, we're gonna paint the whole thing black, like all of the frame, and then just for the slats that go across the top, I picked up Varathane Triple Thick. So this stuff is supposed to go on like one coat is three coats of thickness. And this will be really good because you guys saw that the benches I built when we were living in BC, they got oil stained and grease stained so bad. Like you drop like a little bit of oil on it, if you don't wipe it up right away, it like soaked in and just like swole up and it looked bad. And by the time we were leaving, those benches were an absolute write-off. Like the surface was ruined. So this should be able to keep us from destroying them, and it's a semi-gloss, so it's gonna be like, it's beautiful. This is the solution. This is the thing that I have been waiting for the day that I can justify spending the money on since the dawn of time. I've had this sloppy goose shelf with my paints all over it, or like in our old house in Coquitlam, I had like that little shelf above the toolbox, paint everywhere. I just hate looking at it. I am so fired up to make these cabinets. You guys have no idea. Like this is almost better than the workbench. I got stain on all these pieces. They're just over here drying. And then Chris got this whole thing painted up, and then he's just going around doing like the top because he stood this one up, and then he's gonna do a second coat on like the visible parts, just like the legs and like the outside pieces. So we're making progress, but it says that I have to let my stain dry for a while, so. This is like the Home Depot IKEA special right here. I can like envision it, but I'm still gonna have to use those instructions to figure this out. All right, so IKEA, take notes. Your boys at Home Depot are out here beating you. Look at this. IKEA just sends you Allen keys, bro. They send you the thing for the drill. I did this in like 5 seconds.
Fire it up, brother.
Watch how unlevel this is gonna be. We have a slight decline, but it's in the level mark.
You wanna raise the one side a little bit?
Yeah. Boom. And that, my good friend, how you hang the beautiful husky cabinet.
Buddy. So what I was saying before my memory card filled up and cut me off was that we decided to go with this layout because, like, you guys saw my drawings, I had two different drawings. One was like the whole thing was a workbench and one was like the division. I just personally think it's really cool to like have the division of like workbench, toolbox, and then another workbench. Especially if we do like these cabinets and stuff over here. It turns over there into like a raw workspace where I'm gonna do a lot of beading on stuff. That one's bolted to the wall. I'll put my vise on that one. That one is secured. And this is just like super clean and like showy and it will look super dope. I missed.
Oh buddy, we killed the level too. Happy? You happy boy? Happy boy?
Wow, measurements are perfect. This is the moment we've been waiting for all day. This literally is gonna be the best part. I'm honestly surprised we didn't f*** up sooner, dude. We made it really far. Let's just show them how this doesn't really make any sense. Okay, side to side, we're dead on 80 inches. Wall to here, we got 81 and a half. This is where I think we got hooped. 82.
We have nothing bracing these. Like if we had a 45 here to hold
we could
this,
pull it together.
That or the bottom frame, right? Either we need the bottom frame or we need a 45 here to like suck it in. That's what we did wrong.
You ready?
Yep.
Pretty damn close to level. Oh my god.
Oh yeah. Actually.
Buddy, I would call that golden. We are back in business, buddy. Looks so good. Literally exactly what I was imagining. So something that I have been doing a lot since we moved here, I don't know what's happening, but the time is just escaping me. Like we finished filming this two nights ago. Yesterday was my brother's birthday, so I went to hang out with him for the day. And then today I'm like, oh, I'll come out in the morning, I'll tidy everything in the garage up and finish the video. But like something about us owning this house, I'm putting so much effort into everything that like, it's now nighttime. I spent the entire day out here cleaning things up. Like obviously you guys can tell this place is like spotless, looks amazing. But I just wanted to say sorry for like the delay in the videos. I'm working really hard right now on getting back on track. Like I'm thinking this is gonna be my last video. That's kind of like really, really delayed from all the rest. I think after this one, I should be back in like ready to roll. Kind of like do the three videos a week thing that I was normally doing. But aside from that, look at how insane this looks. First of all, it makes the whole place look like super long. Like the whole garage looks way bigger now. When you stand over here and look, it's intense, dude. And like just like the quality of this finish, I'm just imagining like the BRZ or like a nice car sitting here. So good. So we got the K20 up on engine stand because I would like to start working on this thing. These, I don't know where I want them. So they're just sitting there for now. I was gonna hang them like maybe over here, but I feel like that's too cluttered over here. And then I feel like over there is kind of out of the way. I got my vise back, thankfully. I doubled up layers underneath this guy actually to keep him from tearing through the wood. And yeah, boys, like there's not a whole lot to it. We got our banner up. I love the way this all matches. Like, I don't think I'm gonna get over this. I've never had such like a clean, dope workspace. Like, I'm just picturing me filming videos and like, there's a car here, I turn around and I have like this wicked background behind me. This is gonna be so good. These guys also have little openings under here that are like pretty deep. So we're thinking of putting a couple lights in here to shine down on the wheelie bench. And I'm gonna leave this raw. I kind of like that. I don't think I'm gonna finish it. I like the way it kind of like vibes with the whole table. So now what I gotta do is get some heat going in here and get some cars being built in here because right now we're doing nothing and it's driving me insane. Like all the finishing touches, even just like my little rug. So when you come in from actually, oh my god, it's all melted. It's like a really weird time of the year right now. It was like snowing earlier, but now it's all gone because it's not actually that cold out. The garage is super dope. Thank you guys for your patience. Remember that the merch drop, the gray hoodies and the masks are going for sale November 19th. Sign up for our newsletter on the Committed Cruise website or follow us on Instagram to stay up to date with all that stuff. I feel like I want to just keep talking, but that's probably because it's been like 2 days since I filmed. I should probably end the video. I'm just gonna show you guys one more time. I just want you to take in like, it's taken us longer to do these garage mods. It's taken us longer to get all the stuff done because we just can't not do things ourselves. But like the quality of what we've done. Like, oh my God, man, just look at this bench. This is insane. I got that stupid paint cabinet gone. I hated that paint shelf. Now you don't have to look at all the paint, but I still get to keep all of the things I need. Anyways, that's all I got for you guys. I will catch you guys next time. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm sorry about the delay. I promise to start making some quicker turnaround times in these videos. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will catch you guys next time. Peace out and stay committed. I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna film like an edit. Like I'm gonna take everything out, clean it all up, whatever. I'm gonna come in here and just film like a cool edit of the whole thing, showing it, and then I'm just gonna hold up my photo of what I drew.
Yeah.
And then I'm just gonna be like, bro. Like, cause it looks like exactly like what I drew.